Emma, what we learn in the exhibition at Saint-Pompidou-Metz is a kind of, I don't know, cosmogony between Klein, Fontana, and Gutai. And in fact, normally we don't put links between the three main movement and the artists. So what was going on between them?
In that show, The Sky as a Studio, Klein is not alone, but is really in dialogue with 30 artists from some movements, all involved in the question of dematerialization of the artwork. In the case of Gutai, this is kind of very secret links between Klein and Gutai, but as we know, Klein, through his parents, had very strong connections with Japan. His parents used to spend really a lot of times in Japan in the 20s and continue to develop connections with some art critics, artists also involved in the Gutai aesthetic. And it's not only an aesthetic, but it's an energy. Starting from the body, Klein is a judoka, a very important one, because he wrote a really very important and precious distinction in Japan. And Klein was fascinated through the lens of his parents to the Gutai aesthetic. We know that he collected some reviews printed by the Gutai movements. Some of them are with covers. It's kind of monochrome, a yellow one, a red one. And he was very inspired, perhaps not influenced, but inspired by some sky art festivals. In the show, the visitors can discover quite unknown photographs in which we can see some exhibitions. Sometimes it was a one-day exhibition or a sky art festival. It's a way, just after all the destruction and the bomb on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, to continue to create, but not permanent artworks, but just artworks which will exist just for one day, for one festival, for instance.
Okay. And there was a bomb in Japan, which was also something very strong linked to the sky. The sky becoming a danger, and all the exhibition is about the idea of the sky, right?
Yeah.
But there's also Fontana.
Fontana, we can see exactly at the entrance of the show, we can see some works by Klein, Shiraga. There is a photograph with Fontana in the middle of a destroyed city. And in a way, the destruction of the city for him is also something more metaphoric, like the destruction of the canvas on a painting. And he said, my work is not about destruction, but as soon as you can destruct a canvas, there is also another dimension. So the destruction of the war became a kind of very metaphorical way to reinvent art after the Second World War, but also in the context of the late 50s and beginning of the 60s, where another war was still in their mind. This was more about the nuclear war at the time of the
Cold War.
Of the Cold War. And then for Klein, there is this very strong consciousness that something should happen in the sky. Fontana was a bit older as Klein and the other artists of the Zero Group. And for Fontana, the sky should stay a kind of space for creativity. He said he would love to see, for instance, a firework in the sky instead of bombs.
But do you think they were related, Klein and Fontana?
Yeah, of course. We know that there are a lot of connections through also books, reviews like the Revue Azimut, but also a lot of exhibition in France, in Germany, but also in Milano. And Fontana and Klein already share some exhibition.
So they met?
Yeah, they met, and Klein has been very strongly influenced by the spirit of Fontana.
So Fontana live for Klein.
Yeah. There are a lot of connection between them. Regarding the Gutai artist, it's very complex, really, to follow carefully all the links. But we know that they have been together in some exhibitions and all, as well with the Zero Group. So for me, it was the purpose of the show was really to reread Yves Klein's work, not in connection with the Nouveau Réalisme, but really with the artists who developed their works in the context of the destruction after the war.
Thank you.